They don't make mathematicians like they used to. This is the legacy of Pythagoras today. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Geometry for 8th graders. Big Classroom would have you believe that's all he ever was, the triangle guy. But once upon a time, Pythagoras might have been the most revered of all the Greek philosophers. More than Socrates, Plato, or Aristotle. Far from just the triangle guy, Pythagoras started an entire math cult that made beans illegal, led a war, and ended in fire. Master Pythagoras, I have sought you out because you are the wisest man of this era.
What seems to be the problem?
Look at the men of my family! My hair is doomed!
I'll take this pentagon, and if you appreciate its pentagonality hard enough...
No! Don't fall for alternative medicine! Use what's backed by science! Use Keeps! Keeps is professional care for hair loss from the comfort of your home. Consult with a licensed medical provider online who will tailor a treatment plan to address your specific concerns. Keeps delivers to your door, and you can adjust, pause, or cancel at any time. Whether you're looking to prevent hair loss, stimulate hair growth, or just take better care of the hair you have, Keeps has you covered. Their thickening shampoo and conditioner support healthy hair growth with natural, science-backed ingredients like biotin, caffeine, green tea, and saw palmetto.
For a special offer, go to keeps.com/jackrackham or click the link in the description. That's KEEPS.com/jackrackham. Thanks to Keeps for making this video possible and for the free product.
Pythagoras was a traveling shaman who studied in Egypt and the Levant, maybe even as far as Persia or India. One day he returned from his travels and founded a school in a town in southern Italy named Croton. It was a commune where anyone could learn the ways of the great and mighty Pythagoras, student of the Pharaoh of Egypt and the prophet Zoroaster, a miracle worker who was really good at guessing how many jelly beans are in that jar. His wisdom was available to any who would listen, even women, but all of his students were sworn to absolute secrecy. The cult became so popular and so prestigious that it came to resemble a city within a city, amassing tremendous political and even military power. According to one legend, Pythagoras rallied the city of Croton to war against their neighbor. His disciple, Milo the Wrestler, led the army. The Pythagoreans won the day through the power of being total squares who didn't drink or eat meat or wear nice clothes. Suffice to say, if you came to Pythagoras hoping to learn more about geometry, you were gonna get a lot more than you bargained for. Knock knock? Ding dong?
Welcome, my son. You have come seeking knowledge.
It is as you say, O wise one.
Come, I will show you our ways, and then we will see if you are worthy. No doubt you've heard of my many miracles. You have heard how I was captured by pirates and sat still for 3 days until they worshipped me as a god. It is all true. My travels taught me many wisdoms. Like, for instance, don't kick puppies. One time I saw a guy who is kicking a puppy, and I said unto him, don't do that, man. Because what if it's a guy inside that puppy? Like a guy's soul, when you die, your soul becomes the puppy? Yeah. And that, my son, is why we don't eat puppies. Or cows, goats, sheep. To join us, you must renounce inflicting suffering upon any living creature.
I am ready. I get all my protein from beans.
Never eat the beans! They contain the souls of the dead.
I don't want to be a bean when I die.
Then you must escape the cycle of reincarnation.
Of course. Through good thoughts, good words, and good deeds.
No, you escape reincarnation by being really good at numbers. For lo, I say unto you, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. And lo, the golden ratio is really cool. And lo, 4 is the number of justice, and 7 is the number of opportunity.
And how, O geometric one, does this help us?
Well, you see, pentagons are the shape of health.
So
we put a bunch of pentagons together, and we got this thing.
And that means?
Look, I don't understand what you don't understand.
But things weren't all 4s and 7s for the Pythagoreans. After Croton went to war with its neighbors, a lot of people weren't happy with how much power Pythagoras had over the town. The people of Croton wanted democracy, and Pythagoras said no. The situation reputedly came to a boil with one student named Cylon.
And that's the tour.
Does this mean I can join you?
Oh, do you like eating salads, wearing the same thing every day, and shutting up?
Not really.
Then no!
But I want to join!
Oh, you know what they say, when life hands you lemons.
I'll show you lemons. He burned the school to the ground, killing nearly everyone inside. As for Pythagoras, there are multiple stories of what happened to him, but my favorite involves him running out of the city, chased by an angry mob, and nearly escaping until he came across an impenetrable obstacle.
No.
Please, Pythagoras, please don't step on us.
Never, my children. Never.
You can step on me. I don't like being a bean.
But the teachings of Pythagoras lived on, which is how his mathematical knowledge survived, and how, with the power of hindsight, Pythagoras gradually began to change from a pseudo-Buddhist Zoroastrian pagan shaman to one of the founding fathers of mathematics. The outer circle of Pythagoras' students formed the akousmatikoi, the ones who listen. They were really into shutting up and wearing the same thing every day. For them, the highest virtue was living a life of monkish simplicity, and the highest form of wisdom was memorizing all of Pythagoras' teachings. As such, they refused to accept any new ideas, believing ardently that Pythagoras had discovered all of math and science. His inner circle of students formed the mathematikoi, the ones who math. They lived by following the example of Pythagoras and devoted their lives to studying the numeric properties of the universe. This they did so that they might become even better at worshipping triangles and stuff. Eventually, both schools got absorbed into Plato's school of philosophy, which itself got absorbed into Christianity. A lot of Pythagoras' teachings got chucked out the window, but the early Christians did get a lot of mileage out of inventing theories on the basis of certain numbers being extra special and numbery. Curiously enough, in medieval times, Pythagoras was known mostly for being something like the inventor of music. He didn't invent music, really, but one of his mathematical experiments was discovering the ratios between musical instruments that created musical harmony. And that reputation continued through the Renaissance, where everyone was really into the idea of a perfectly ordered cosmos. And hey, the Pythagorean school believed in a universe where the Earth wasn't at the center, and where every celestial body orbited a primordial fire with an almost musical resonance. But increasingly, throughout the Renaissance and the Enlightenment, people began to favor philosophers like Aristotle, with a bigger body of work and more robust methods of observation than, boy, numbers sure are cool. And thus, the bean hugger who nearly died in an arson attack was forgotten in favor of a squared plus b squared equals c squared. The past, my friends, truly is a foreign country.